Meredith, by the way, you do look beautiful. And Kenny, you both make a wonderful couple. And I'm very proud father today. I knew right from the beginning that Meredith would be special, and she is. She's down to earth, she's adventurous, she's conscientious, and not to mention a great cook. And I'm sure Kenny knows a great catch. Every father hopes his daughter will find a reliable, sensible, and considerate partner. As much as you try not to interfere with their lives, you hope your children will make the right choices in life. And Ken is a perfect match. And I'm proud of my daughter for choosing so well.
Ken, you and I have been friends for over 25 years. And I can honestly say it's been some of the best years of my life. We've had some amazing memories together. You've been a great friend to me, and I want you to know that means a lot to me and how much I respect our friendship. So it's really special when you find someone you share so much in common with. And this does hold true for Ken and Meredith. You both do so much together, whether it's gardening, cooking, going to your wine tasting events, eating free-range chicken, organic peppers, and all that healthy crap. You guys work out perfect together.
Welcome to the family. No returns accepted, okay? I'd like everybody to raise their glass and a toast to the bride and groom. Love you.
We are gathered here in the sight of God and of His church to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. This is an honorable estate which God Himself has instituted and blessed. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into inadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God.
A soulmate is someone who has locks that fit our keys and keys to fit our locks. When we feel safe enough to open the locks, our truest selves step out and we can be completely and honestly who we are. Each unveils the best part of the other. No matter what else goes wrong around us, with that one person, we're safe in our own paradise. Our soulmate is someone who shares our deepest longings, our sense of direction. Our soulmate is the one who makes life come to life.
At night, there was the feeling that we had come home, feeling no longer alone, walking in the night to find the other one there and not gone away. Often a man wishes to be alone and a woman wishes to be alone too. And if they love each other, they are jealous of that in each other. But I can say, truly say, we never felt that. We could feel alone when we were together, alone against the others. We were never lonely, never afraid when we were together.
That's the intention of marriage. It is right there from the very beginning of creation. Scripture says it was not good for man to be alone, so He made unto him a helper. Not to be below him, not to be above him, but to be side by side, for she was taken from an area near his heart.
I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. It doesn't go all the way. There we go.
I give you this ring as a sign of my love and faithfulness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
So we would pray this afternoon, as we celebrate with your families and with your friends this wonderful occasion, that you would always hold one another in your arms as the Lord holds you in his arms.
For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mare's little sis. Gonna tell you all a story, but in an awesome mix. Don't mind a few jokes. You know some guests will get roasted, but as soon as I'm finished, then we all can get toasted. Having Mare as a big sister was quite a childhood. We fought like cats and dogs, but now it's all good. No guy would do, not for my girl. But then along came Kenny, and now he's our world. They kept things on the DL. They didn't tell a soul, cause my mom's got a big mouth, and well, you all know Ro. Now we've made it to this day. You know, I was a bit concerned, but glad you finally tied the knot, cause now it's my turn. Seriously though, I wish you love and laughter. Kenny, Mare, and Emma, may they live happily ever after.
Hi, Kenneth. Take you, Meredith, to be my wife.
Hi, Meredith. Take you, Kenneth, to be my husband.
From this day forward.
To join with you and share.
All that is to come.
And I promise to be faithful to you.
And I promise to be faithful to you until death parts us.
Until death parts us. Well, she was an American girl, raised on promises. She couldn't help thinking that there was a little more life.
Now that Kenneth and Meredith have committed themselves to each other in holy matrimony and have given themselves to each other by their solemn pledges and have declared the same before God and these witnesses, I pronounce them to be husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Is it good? Got a good one. This is your idea.
Ken, Meredith, may your days be filled with success, may your nights be filled with love, and may the children that you one day have fill the both of you with enough love and memories that last you a lifetime. to Ken and Meredith.